Our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Arrowhead Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They're set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with the Jacksonville Jaguars. And a welcome in, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden, and Charles, so much gets made about offensive comparisons. Here's a matchup where the defenses may just take center stage.
Yeah, we're usually talking about guys scoring touchdowns. How about the guys who prevent them and change the momentum of the game when they take the ball away? I love those ball hawks in the secondary. People after my own heart.
Cairo Santos ready to get us started, and we are underway from Arrowhead. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it, and they'll take it out to the 25. So here's the first drive now for the Jags. They'll be led out by their 6'3 quarterback, the former Wolverine at Michigan. It's Chad Henne.
Yeah, he's had shots at starting in both Miami and Jacksonville. Neither has worked out over a long period of time. But he knows the game, understands what he has to do in the offense, and now he's trying to put it all together as a starter again.
Let's go now. And now movement here right away. Maybe a sign of things to come with this crowd.
False start offense.
And yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five.
Still first down.
Chiefs are going to get him. Ramiq Wilson coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye. That happened fast and a big sack. First rounder from LSU, it's Leonard Fournette. And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. And the offensive unit now for the Jaguars.
The Jacksonville Jaguars offense in 2016 truly expected to pick up where they left off in 2015, where they were a big play offense by the end of the season, whether it was running the ball or throwing it. But they had some inconsistency in the offensive line and weren't able to reach those numbers. They're hoping for a repeat of 2015 with their 2017 squad.
And that is incomplete.
Are we on the same page here, partner? Because I think they have the right idea. Just take what you can get on third and forever.
Yeah, in real life, I'd say yes. It's just these video games are tempting. You want to go downfield with it.
I like the way you evolved. Yeah. You know, you learned how to play it the Madden way.
Brad Nortman in his sixth year in the league on to punt it away. Back deep for Kansas City, DeAnthony Thomas. Returnable for Thomas. They'll call that a punt of 59 yards. Tough to do better than that. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Fresh off his second Pro Bowl, Alex Smith bringing out the Kansas City Chiefs. And with that Pro Bowl last year, had a great season. A lot of high hopes in Kansas City this year.
Plenty of high hopes, and Alex Smith hopes to be that guy still leading this team. But he's getting some pressure because they moved up in the draft to pick Pat Mahomes out of Texas Tech. And he appears to be the quarterback of the future. But can Alex Smith stay the quarterback of now?
Now it's the Princeton man. This is Spencer Ware. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. The starting 11 offensively for the KC Chiefs. And at running back, Spencer Ware, the go-to guy, but they've got some other good options there, don't they?
They certainly do. They've got a rookie by the name of Kareem Hunt, who seems to have locked down the number 2 spot. But how about the competition for number 3? C.J. Spiller, formerly a number 1 running back in the NFL, he's battling out the incumbent guy there, Charkandrick West.
They run again with Ware. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gain, they can run that play on any down.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Now a first down throw. It's Smith. He's got it. It's Escobar. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
They'll run now with Ware. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And we take you through the starting defense for Jacksonville.
Malik Jackson won a Super Bowl in Denver before moving to Jacksonville as a big-time free agent. And he justified that signing, too. 6.5 sacks, a career high in 2016. I love what he did off the field, partner. Did you see this little note we've got on him? 181 pet adoptions made possible by Malik Jackson paying the fees in the offseason.
Strong fella, soft heart. Second down, here's Smith. Kelce imposing his will. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Chiefs first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Way forward here for a modest gain. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Off of play action. Here's Smith. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. The tight end Kelce was the intended target, and it's 3rd down.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
Throwing on 3rd down, Smith. And it's complete to Kelce. And he gets this down to the 18, good enough for a first down. The Kansas City first, Smith fighting his fellow Pro Bowler, Kelce.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
On the ground, this is Ware, able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
2nd down of the offense in search of 6 yards. Now, prior to the snap, we hit all zeros as time has run out on the first quarter of play. Nothing, nothing, our score, and we're back to Arrowhead after this. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. They've got it second and six to start things out. Here's Smith. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Now Smith on third down. And he's got his man. It's Escobar. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the five at the four. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. You're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Backwards on this one, losing yardage to the seven. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Brad, wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
Here's Smith now on second down. And this is going to be caught. No, they say it's incomplete. Albert Wilson, the intended receiver there. And that'll make it third down.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already... probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one.
And the coach has decided to challenge this play. He has tossed down the red flag. This drive, they're 2 for 2 on third down conversions, but they need 7 yards here. Out of the gun, Smith. A bullet throw, but incomplete. Looked like they had a window to get that in there, but a good job rallying defensively.
Excellent timing, no pass interference. The hit jars it loose, and now they force them into a decision. Do you go for it on fourth down or kick the field goal?
Here's Cairo Santos now for the Chiefs field goal. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And the Chiefs are out to a 3-0 lead. So a 15-play drive. Can't believe that only resulted in three, but it did.
That is somewhat amazing, isn't it? When you hold the ball that long, run offense that well, yet only put 3 points on the board, it has to be a little bit of a disappointment, doesn't it?
Has to.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25.
CD, let's talk quarterbacking as the Jags come back onto the field. What do you see them doing? Bortles, Henny, they've even got Brandon Allen, who has a great first name. What do you think?
He does have an excellent first name.
Got a good ring to him.
And he does have a way of having teams respond to him. But let's face it, it's going to come down to Blake Bortles or Chad Henne, which is a bit of a surprise considering they kind of went all in on Blake Bortles picking up his fifth-year option. But if it's an open competition, Chad Henne could sneak in there and take it because he doesn't turn the ball over that much. But let's face it, wild card time, Brandon Allen might get his shot.
Sixth round pick last year out of Arkansas.
The best receivers we know always tease their quarterbacks to, hey, no matter what you do, you cannot overthrow me.
Here we go.
Well, guess what? That's exactly what happened on that play. Normally, they time it up pretty well, but on that one, he just overshot him.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
And Leonard Fournette impressing there with that run. It's hard to believe that no Jacksonville Jaguar has broken 1,000 yards since Maurice Jones-Drew in 2011. And Leonard Fournette could be that guy.
Even with the ankle injury last year at LSU, still averaged 6.5 yards per carry.
And absolutely intimidated opposing defenses. A lot of guys simply didn't want to tackle him. Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Play fake here on first down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, we'll send you to Orlando and Larry Ridley, as he'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. But no touchdown. These guys need to play some touchdowns to talk about.
Things are too easy for him right now back in the studio. Come on, guys. Help the man out. Give him something to talk about.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Great changeup there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
Well, the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside, make a move in that direction. And you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him and the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way.
And the eighth play on this drive coming up. The red zone now. They'll look to throw. Middle of the field, it's Robinson. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Allen Robinson, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Jags are able to cash in for six.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Jason Myers now for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays. And it results in a touchdown for Jacksonville. Here's Myers now to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Here's the Jags defense now as they head back out there. And last time out, they gave up the chip shot field goal, but obviously could have been worse than that. I think they felt pretty good about only giving up 3.
No doubt about it. Anytime an offense gets into the red zone, the thinking naturally for the defense is, okay, 3 points. We're going to give up 3 here, but let's make it no more than that. They met their goal.
On the other side, though, the offense, they weren't very happy.
No, because there's an opportunity. Once you get to the red zone, you're not thinking about kicking a field goal. You're thinking about how do you get into the end zone, and when you don't, You walk off the field feeling a little bit of failure on that drive.
Yeah, who will have the better feeling at the end of this drive?
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. To throw on second down is Smith. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Smith. Caught here by Conley. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Chris Conley, 60 yards. And the Chiefs are in for six.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Already looking forward.
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
Cairo Santos on to try the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So the drive there, they went 80 yards in three plays. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing.
That he's taken down. A Chiefs sack. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one.
Let's go now. Right 18. Right 18.
Now Henning. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play. And that's going to make it third down and 10.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he's going to be out of bounds at the 39. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
And a catch made here by Marquise Lee. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. He'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Robinson. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half.
Right 18. Right 18.
They'll look to throw here. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A gain of four that time as the drive continues.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over at the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
Smith on first down. They complete it to Hill. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. Smith. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. So we've come upon halftime here in Arrowhead with the Chiefs on top as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Larry Ridley. He's standing by with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. The Chiefs are happy to be in front right now and just want to play two more solid quarters. The Jaguars just want to come out after the half and claw their way back into the game. All right, let's get it going. Let's roll those first half highlights. Now, first and 10, Penny's on point with the throw, and this play will go for 6. The lead grows to 4. We move late into the second. Conley's got nobody around him on the deep pass. And this goes 60 yards for the score. So that'll bring our halftime report to a close. We'll go back now to Arrowhead Stadium for the start of the third quarter.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is fielded at the goal line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
To throw is Smith. And Conley's got it over the middle. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And the Jags grab it. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line.
He makes so many catches that are so tough, so acrobatic, so difficult, that often surprises me when they actually turn the ball over. You know, when the ball actually comes free. It's amazing sometimes because of what we see them do on so many different plays.
Had the catch, but couldn't control it on the contact. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number 2. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
A little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails.
Now the pressure gets there and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Justin Houston in from his linebacker spot. He's able to drop it for a loss of about 10.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decide to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
Here's a carry for a former starter. This is T.J. Yeldon, and he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15.
Well, after getting the ball in prime position to score after a fumble recovery, you think you're in a great spot. But the defense on the field is saying not so fast, and they've held firm on the first two plays.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. They are able to get 9 yards out of that, but now it's fourth down.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. And Myers able to knock it through, and that will knot us up at 10. So he missed a field goal earlier, but he says not this time, and he's able to knock it through to give his guys 3.
And that's all you want as a kicker, a chance to redeem yourself. You got to have a short memory if you're going to survive at this level, and he's able to get back on track.
Then he'll take this across the 25, a couple of extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive, a little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown, but they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Smith now looking to throw on second down, and that is incomplete here. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
On third down, Smith caught. Kelce, left side. A gain of 7, and they pick up the first.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Here's Smith to throw on second down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. On first down, Smith. He's got the hookup with Conley. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And
As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. But we'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. We're back now in KC. Knotted up here at 10. That's our score as we begin quarter number four. They run it here. Where? And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at third and one. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. The bottom line is he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down at a yard.
Well, big man with ball met bigger man on the other side of the line. A really nice play for the defense.
So a big one coming now for Cairo Santos. This to break our fourth quarter tie. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they will take the lead at 13-10. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
After the main field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But I also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Allen Robinson, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
Here we go, here we go.
Henning. Throw left side, complete. That's Lee. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll try and run for it with Fournette, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
Oh, pardon me. That play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, it took a little more time off the clock, making him do it that way, didn't they?
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Chiefs are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. To throw on second down, Smith goes to Ware on the screen. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Got to credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Smith to throw on third down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Barry Church. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line. You got the slim lead late and the football, so why are you throwing it there?
Remember during the year when we asked one of the head coaches, you know, if you're in this spot, why would you throw the ball? And he talked about trust in his quarterback and trust in his offense.
But still.
And then at the end he kind of went, yeah, not really a good reason.
Right. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
The drive will start with an option going left. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper. Now the Jags are moving quickly in the hurry up. He'll look to throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Derek Johnson. And he'll be stopped shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return.
Well, I don't think we'll have to look very hard to find our play of the game. That was an absolutely monstrous big play right there. Backs to the wall. The offense has it in the red zone, driving for the winning score. And he says, not on my watch. And that is one happy bunch on the sidelines.
And out come the Chiefs now. They have the 3-point lead. Defense did their job. Now, late game. Although it looks good, you know the coaches, they haven't counted this as a victory yet.
I agree with you totally. Big applause for the defense, but no one has taken their headset off on the sidelines. They don't believe this game is over. The offense has to close this one out by taking care of the football.
They'll try to close it out now. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So second and medium, second and 5 now. And he'll give it here to his running back. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. And now the Jags going to signal for another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The Chiefs on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This time it's 3rd and 3. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. pulled in at the 24. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. We put our attention now on the Chiefs' defense. They've got a situation where a field goal ties it. How do you defend this? Because you obviously don't want to give up the touchdown. How aggressive do you get?
That's always the key, isn't it? Where is the line on aggressiveness to over-aggressiveness? And I think most coordinators are looking at it like, run your regular defense, add some pressure packages, because really the 35-yard line is the one.
Betty can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Tom Mahaly in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. Back to throw. They'll check this one off to Fournette. He finds an opening past the 40. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. The Jaguars on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. Here it's third and three. He's back to throw. And he's got it to Hurns. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. First down, Jacksonville. The passing game looking sharp on this drive for the Jags. On second down, here's Fournette. And he stopped immediately there. Back-to-back stops, make it third and 10. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. They'll look to throw. Dumps it off to Fournette. It's a gain of 9 yards, and it'll be fourth down.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to tie things up in the final minute. And his kick here is good. And that's going to tie us at 13. And we have free football overtime. Here we go, my friend.
And the way this game played out, this is exactly how it should end, going to overtime, because neither one got an advantage today.
It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A big one there for the Jags. 18 yards, first down.
Well, there's a reason he was the first running back taken. You saw the ability there, the ability to be physical and get downhill. And how about him breaking off a nice game there?
There's some Adrian Peterson comparisons out there now. That's high praise. Do you think that they're warranted?
Running style, very similar.
The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Fournette, a first down carry. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
They'll run it again with Fournette. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. He lost two there, and it's third down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
They'll set up to throw. They go with the screen. It's Yeldon. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. 10 yards there. Good enough for a Jags first down.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
They go back to the ground now with Fournette. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. And they need 5 yards on third down here to keep this opening drive of OT alive. They're going to look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
So on now comes the kicker. It's Jason Myers. This to at least get him a lead here in overtime. And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And that will break our tie and give him a 3-point lead. Now remember, this one is not over, but with the time running short here in this overtime, that could very well be the game winner.
Yeah, remember now, the other team does get a possession, but when the clock runs out, that's it. So that was a well-calculated drive to use up the majority of the clock and leave your opponent with little to no time left.
This is taken at the 3. He's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Alex Smith and company heading back out there now. And the passing game, I mean, look at the numbers. It's fallen off. When a team is struggling, sometimes you look at the quarterback. When the quarterback starts to struggle, who goes over and picks him up?
Yeah, that's always a big one, isn't it? Usually, there's a quarterback whisperer somewhere. And what I mean by that is, whether it's an assistant coach, whether it's one of his best friends on the team, someone that can get in his ear.
Oh, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. We were just treated to an absolute dandy in this one. A great finish in overtime with a long field goal. Everybody, including us, on the edge of their seats. Quite a game.
And it's rare that you get a game into overtime that it doesn't turn out to be a dandy, right? That's what we saw here. And just what you were talking about, a long field goal to win it. So definitely not a gimme. So there was tension all the way through until the ball went through the post.
But it did go through the post. Ice water was in his veins. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL.